once I prove my worth. And then I meet the wizard, what I've waited for since birth. And with all his wizard wisdom, by my looks he won't be blinded. Do you think the wizard is dumb, or like Munchkin, so small-minded? No, he'll say to me, I see who you truly are, a girl on whom I can rely. And that's how we'll begin, the wizard and I.
Hi, I'm Regina Wasser-Haley, here with UAlbany TV. I'm here with Gregory Maguire, a 1976 UAlbany graduate. He's also the acclaimed author of Wicked, The Life and Times of the Wicked Witch of the West. This book is now a Tony Award-winning Broadway musical. So, Mr. Maguire, what's it like coming back to campus after 30 years of having graduated?
Well, I knew about the campus long before I got here because I grew up in Pine Hills. Indeed, the towers being erected almost through my childhood seemed to me a little bit like, you know, the shining towers of the Emerald City. And when I was accepted at SUNY and came here, I had as a file for my transcripts the ledger Oz. I called this Oz. I lived at home but took the bus, the green bus, up to Oz. So to be back here, it's just nice to be back.
So can you tell us a little bit about what might be different or the same for UAlbany students today as opposed to when you went to school here?
Well, one of the things I was remembering as I came up onto the podium is that there was only one requirement, academic requirement, for a person graduating with an undergraduate degree, and that academic requirement, above and beyond the requirements of your major, was to take one gym course. So I took my first gym course, my only gym course, my freshman year of college here, and I was terrible at it. I was a dreadful gym student, and I was so glad that I didn't have to take anything else. What might be the same, I suspect, and you could enlighten me if I'm wrong, is that I found at UAlbany, SUNY when I was a kid, but UAlbany, what I suspect is still present here, which was the capacity for teachers to think a little bit beyond what the catalog said and to extend themselves in such a way as to make an education tailored for an individual. This is a huge place, and I was and remain a very small individual. But I remember several times when teachers allowed me entrance into classes for which I didn't necessarily have the right prerequisite. Indeed, I took my first children's literature course in the library school when I was a sophomore. That was a graduate level course, but I was able to talk myself into the class, and the teacher, Professor Orsini, was very welcoming, in a sense gave me a little bit of a leg up into what would be a long career in thinking about the value of children's stories in the lives of American adults.
In Wicked, you take the character of the Wicked Witch of the West and you turn her into your protagonist. Can you tell us a little bit more about your heroine in the story?
My heroine is named Elphaba, and I named her after the initials for the original author of The Wizard of Oz, L. Frank Baum, LFB, Elphaba. I aspirated it as a way to tip my hat to all the good work he had done to bring this story into the ranks of American myth, really. When I started, I thought I was going to create a real monster, just like Margaret Hamilton seems on the screen, you know.
I'll get you, and little dog.
I'll get you, my pretty, and your little dog, too.
I thought, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make her be like a Hannibal Lecter, like a Hitler. But as soon as I started writing about her, she began to unfold herself to be more complex, like most human beings when you get to know them, to have sides that were good, sides that were confusing, as well as a talent and an ability sometimes to do the wrong thing. She turned out, in effect, to be human.
I do believe I have been changed for the better.
The book has since been turned into an award-winning play. Can you tell us a little bit about that, that experience and how that feels?
I can have a scholarly demeanor when I want to. I look a little bit like my Scottish Presbyterian forebears. So when the composer Stephen Schwartz came to me and said, I think this would make an absolutely wonderful play, I crossed my arms and I said, stroked what little beard I had and said, I don't know. He explained that my character Elphaba was like a 19th century heroine and had big emotions, pre-Freudian emotions. She could stalk to the end of a stage and sing her heart out, a soliloquy in sense, and people would get it. And so I said, well, that sounds interesting. But really, in my heart of hearts, I was thinking, you know, Broadway, you know, what's not to love? So I was delighted with the prospect. I never thought it would be the great success that it's become, though.
I understand you're revisiting the Wicked series now for the third time.
Yes.
Could you tell us a little bit about that?
My new book, which is in my knapsack, leaning against one of these pillars, is called A Lion Among Men. And it goes back and once again starts back at the story of Dorothy to figure out who was the cowardly lion, how did he come to be the way he was, and is there any chance for a salvation for someone who has been tarnished with a terrible reputation? Not unlike perhaps Elliot Spitzer.
"Don't come down for at least a year," she sang out, giddy as a lambkin. "Make that two. I might be old as sin itself, but once I start rotting, it won't be pretty. If I hammer at the cellar door, don't open it. I'm probably just collecting for some public charity in hell."
Thank you so much, Gregory Maguire, for this interview today. And we look forward to seeing your reading later and looking forward to your book coming out in the fall.
Thank you very much. I'm looking forward to it as well. I appreciate it.
The Wizard and Lady.